Hi everyone, I'm Leo and welcome back to our App Inventor tutorials. So what we are going to do today is this, the test box input for our apps. So just to make things more interesting, what we are going to do is an app just like one of our previous lessons. That's the color generator that we, instead of using a button to randomly generate a color for us, this time we are going to input the RGB value directly. So first thing, create a new project, and we need three text boxes for inputting three different values, and we may also need some labels here just to indicate what the value we are inputting. Also we need a button so the color will be generated based on the values when we click the button. And lastly, we need a canvas just to show the color we just input. So just do some very quick changes about the properties, like changing the test and also the test size. And here, remember the canvas, just use the fill parent and it can take the rest of our screens. So I think that's the basic setups for our designer view. And let's go to the blocks view now. Okay, now here we didn't name our labels and test boxes, so well, never mind, as long as we know what we are going to do. And here's not too many of the components, so it's still okay. But remember, in larger projects, always rename your components. So the first test box is red value, second one is the green, and the third one is blue. So first thing we need to do, go to button, because all the operation is going to be done when we click the button. So when we click our buttons, we need to change our canvas background color, which is here. We need to set it to a color of something, remember? So here the color, just like the random color generator, we need to use these blocks to create a color based on three different values. So these values are will be stored as a list, and the color part we'll use the list to create a color component, so we can assign this color to other components like the canvas or text or labels. So instead of using three different digits or numbers, we are going to use the text of our text boxes this time. So here under text box, we should be able to find a text, and this is a variable. Just drag it and we need three of them, and this is the simplest way to do this. By making a list of tests, if we input numbers, we can still make a color, but if what we input is not a number, things will gonna happen and your app cannot be run. So about this test numbers issue, I will cover it in next lesson, but now just make it simple like this. Okay, this is pretty much about the blocks, and now we can try our apps here. Let's open our emulator. Okay, here. So well, I didn't change the test size here, I'm sorry, but you know what we have to do, right? So we have to input some values. So for example, I want my color to be red. I just input 255. The green is 0, and the blue is also 0. And then we click this make color, and you can see it's red here. For example, we want to mix red and blue together, and this should output a purple color. So I also input 255 and click the make color, and you can see it's purple. What if we also set green to 255? It is going to be white. And lastly, if we all set it to be 0, the color should be black. Okay, so you can try it, like different values, not just 255, maybe 100, and maybe green would be 23, or blue is going to be 78, and you can see what color you are going to mix. Wow, is it cool? So just try to play with these numbers, and yeah, we will cover more about these input fields in future lessons. So remember, always practice your coding, and I will see you guys next week.